We're here in the KX Country Clubhouse. That looks a little different today. We're at Universal Music Group, their office in Toronto. We're with Sam Hunt.
We'll have a house party. We don't need nobody. Turn your TV off. Break that boombox out. We'll wake up.
How are you doing, man?
Good, man. How are you?
Good to see you. Yeah, I'm great. Lots going on in Toronto today. We got the Jays in town, although you're wearing the Braves hat.
Yeah,
we won't fault you for that.
Forgive me.
That's home for you. We won't fault you for that. The Indy's on as well. I don't know. Yeah. Are you into any racing stuff?
No, but I think they come through Nashville now. It's kind of the craze here recently, I feel like. Or maybe that's the F1 over
okay,
the TV
yeah,
show.
Yeah. Because you would have grew up closer to like NASCAR right? Like that
thing,
was like Atlanta Motor Speedway and
Talladega. Go to that race a couple times.
That must have been a trip. Yeah,
that was an experience. Yeah.
And then, I mean, life has changed a little bit for you in the last year. I guess just over a year. You got a 1-year-old now.
Yep.
Like, how has that adjustment been? You know, kind of just adjusting into dad life now.
Yeah, it's been a smooth transition for me. I don't know. You know, I've got a lot to learn still, but every day is just a ton of fun. Like every day is like Christmas morning. You know, as a kid on Christmas morning, it's amazing. Just having a ball. I've got another one on the way coming in October. I think it'll get a little more hectic when the new one gets here. Because Hannah, I have to say, my wife is pulling a lot of the weight right now. And I'm kind of moral support, but she can only do so much. So with two, I'm going to have to step it up.
Yeah, you're going to step your game up.
Yeah.
I was going to ask you what you were doing with your spare time, but now I guess that kind of makes sense. That's a lot of your spare time is being taken up by that now.
Yeah.
Like, have you gotten Lucy out to any gigs, like Little Baby Earmuffs or anything like
last
that?
Last night she came out for the first time.
Come
on, they're
on
the road
awesome.
With me, but she's typically asleep by the time I go home. But last night, Hannah got her up and she came out and got the earphones and all. And there's a moment where I go out into the crowd and go up and play on a stage that's out further up towards the lawn, and they were out there hanging. So that was pretty special.
That's a special moment.
Yeah.
Yeah. Music was, correct me if I'm wrong, music wasn't necessarily the first choice here. Like, you were almost either that close to becoming a professional football player.
Well, I don't know if I was that close. Probably a little farther away than that. But, but I had an opportunity legitimate enough to pursue, and that when that didn't work out, I had just really gotten into music and started entertaining the idea of pursuing music as a career, although I had no idea what that really meant. Took off to Nashville after football didn't really work out, I'd been playing football since I was 6 years old, and it had really become life about junior year of high school. So 7 years later, my life was football. So I was just about ready to get into something else. Music was not necessarily the obvious choice, but the choice I made. And luckily it worked out, and I've had a really, really good time.
I think you've done quite well for yourself.
It has worked out. Thanks to a lot of dumb luck and persistence.
You were self-taught. Like, you picked up a guitar, and you taught yourself how to play a guitar.
Yeah, I taught myself how to play, and I'm not a great guitar player, but I got good enough that I could start to write songs.
Right, of course.
And that's really where my passion was, is the storytelling and figuring out how to write the songs.
And then you picked up this guitar, and you taught yourself, and then now, you know, I think one of the first songs you learned was a Kenny Chesney song.
Mm-hmm.
And then fast forward a couple of years, and you're writing songs for Kenny Chesney in a song that went number one.
Yeah.
Like, talk about that, man. How cool is
that? Incredible. That still is, you know, probably the biggest highlight of my career, because it was the moment that this dream or idea became real and tangible. But you're right. That was a full circle deal, because that was one of the first songs I learned on guitar was a Kenny Chesney song. He was kind of the guy back when I was in high school. Mm-hmm. He was, you know, doing the stadium tours.
I want to be cool like him.
Yeah, he was You know, a lot of buddies had listened to his music for a long time. And
right.
The guy who introduced me to guitar, my buddy of mine who I play football with, got a guitar. And he's kind of the one who inspired me to go get a guitar when we graduated high school. And he was a big Kenny Chesney fan. So all the songs we were learning were Kenny Chesney songs, because those are the songs he knew. So he was just showing me what he knew. Of course, it was just three or four chords. But, yeah, that was pretty neat to get a song recorded by Kenny.
And, you know, fast forward a couple of years again, and now you have an arsenal of hit songs, pro football player hit songs, like Save Some Talent from the Rest of Us. But have the lyrics changed now, though? Like, have the theme, I should say, of the lyrics changed at all in the last year? Like, you had, you know, one baby, now you got another one on the way. Has it changed a little bit?
Yeah, it has changed. I'm drawing from the inspiration that a child brings into your life. I'm not necessarily writing songs directly about fatherhood or family life, but I'm so moved by the experience that I just feel there's a well of creativity there that had sort of, don't want to say depleted completely, but it, you know, I just aged out of that era in my life where there seemed to be a bottomless well of inspiration.
Right,
and I moved on from that, and it's like, where do you draw your inspiration from now? And that definitely am inspired by my family and kids, but it's so sacred that I'm a little intimidated to write specifically about that, these experiences, but we'll see where it goes from here.
And then, so now you have this new song, Outskirts, and so what was the meaning or the inspiration behind this one then?
It was, I write down a lot of titles on my phone, and that was a title I had. I thought, I just like the word Outskirts. I wonder how I could write a song called Outskirts. And then went on a little writing retreat and started singing that chorus, and I had been in the city for a lot of years, and I was reaching a point in my life where, you know, when I'd go home, as soon as I'd get out where the city disappeared, I felt the pull of home and being out in a more rural environment.
Right. Yeah.
You know, you got to live in town to pursue country music. Is kind of ironic, but you live there for years and years, and you're in that routine, and you get back, you know, to your roots. I guess it's kind of a cliche, but it's real. You know, you feel it when you get back out there, and you're like, this is who I am. This is where I'm from, and this song is kind of about that pool. Yeah.
And so now you're back in Canada. We're in Toronto. We're right down in the thick of it right now. Is there anything when you get back to Canada that you look forward to? Is there a spot that you got to hit if you got to go and get some ketchup chips or something, like anything like that?
Food's always good up here. As I've, you know, growing up, I thought that like we have like Red Lobster, Applebee's, Longhorn, like that was like prom night. You know, it's still fine, but as I've gotten to eat some good food over the years, you know, I appreciate good food a little more. Canada, you guys have some really good food.
Yeah, we got to get Sam some poutine before we get out of here.
Yeah, I've been on the poutine train before.
big announcement. You're going to be performing at the CCMAs. Talk about that, man.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to being back. I've been to the CCMAs a couple times now. I've just, you know, the Canadian country fans have embraced me in a way that I really, really appreciate. And, you know, we played Toronto years ago, opening up for Lady Antebellum, and we were the early acts, and folks showed up early.
Right, yeah.
We played pop-up shows around town, and people show up and sing the songs. Really, the only people back then that knew the songs when they were first coming out were like folks around where I grew up, and then these little pockets of Canada. And it's just, folks love music up here. Folks love having a good time, and it seems like young folks up here are a little more tuned in to what's happening than in some parts of the States. So they at least embraced me for whatever reason, so I've always appreciated that and felt a sense of loyalty to the country music fans up here.
Well, we love you in Toronto, and I think I would speak on behalf of all Torontonians when I ask this question. Can you tell us about Haley from Toronto? What can you tell us about Haley from Toronto?
Yeah, it's it was really just, it, what's the word? Is antithesis? Is that the right word? I don't know. It's just sort of a juxtaposition to the girl who, you know, I'm singing to in the song.
Right.
The girl who is from a long way from home, you know, and who's not her. And so that's where that came from. But loosely based on, you know, a past life, I guess you could say, meeting new people from different parts of the world. But that was actually a line that I didn't plan on using in the song, but my producer convinced me to leave it in there. So
we're glad you did, because I feel like people are going to go nuts when you play that at Bud Stage.
That's funny.
I mean, you got that, and I feel like there's probably going to be a lot of signs out there too. There's going to be a couple Haleys from Toronto.
I saw a sign the other night. Somebody up front we were playing the Stampede, and it said Haley from Calgary.
It's already begun.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, Sam, thanks so much. Sam Hunt joining us in the KX Country Clubhouse here at Universal Music Group, their head office. And all the best with the new single and the tour and CCMAs and everything you got going on, man.
Thanks, man. It's good to be back in Canada. Appreciate it.